Hi viewer, I welcome you to Tourim TV. It is the station where you watch and learn. I'll be taking you through Geography Form 4, Lesson Number 21. The topic it is Wildlife and Tourism. I'm your tutor, Lucy Muthoni. Welcome. Let us look at our lesson goals. We are going to define the wildlife and look at the factors influencing wildlife distribution in East Africa. So, by the end of the lesson, the learner should be able to define wildlife and also state the factors that influence the wildlife distribution in East Africa. We'll start by definition. Definition of the wildlife refers to the undomesticated plants and animals in their natural habitat. Remember, when we talk about wildlife, it involves both the plant and animals, and they should remain in their natural habitats. So that are not influenced by the human being, that have not been planted by the human being, that is what we refer to it as the wildlife. The wildlife is natural vegetation. We have the insects, birds, and animals living in the bushes and forests. When we talk about the fish, we get and other aquatic organisms, they live in the rivers, oceans, lakes, and seas. So you can get, we have a variety of wildlife, all the things that we can refer to them as wildlife, all the natural vegetation, all the insects, all the birds, all the animals that live in the bushes, in the forest. And also those organisms that live in the rivers, oceans, lakes, and seas. Let us look at the factors influencing wildlife distribution in East Africa. One of them, it is the climate. Now, when we talk about the climate, we have areas receiving high rainfall that is reliable and evenly distributed all year round, leading to the growth and development of big and large forests. And remember, this big and large forest, it is where we have these plants, these animals being found. So those areas will attract high wildlife. These forests are all themselves part of the wildlife and are homes to several herbivores like emperors, water bugs, antelopes, as well as the carnivorous animals, that is the lions. We also have leopards. These that are found in Mount Kenya forest. Areas receiving low rainfall lead to the extensive grassland. So even those areas that are experiencing low rainfall, they also encourage some natural vegetation, some wildlife, that is the grassland. And the grassland, it is home of herbivorous animals and carnivorous animals. We go to the second factor, which is the soil type. We have the termite and rodent live in red volcanic soils because they are warmer. So you go and get that termites and rodents, you can only get them in red volcanic soils. This is because those soils are warm. Forests thrive well in deep, fertile soils. So those soils that are deep and fertile, they will favor the growth of the forest, hence ensuring that the other natural habitat that is associated with forest is found. Then we have the papyrus plants. They do well in our water-logged soils. Then we go to number three, drainage and presence of water bodies. Well-drained areas support growth of many plants and animals compared to the water-logged areas. So those areas that are properly drained, they will support the growth of forests. They will also support the growth of other natural vegetation. So as a result, they will also encourage the living of the animals. That is the herbivorous and the carnivorous animals. Now, when you talk about the water-rocked areas, you are going to get that in these water-rocked areas, the only plant that can do well, it is the peppers. And the vegetations that do well in the water-rocked areas. Fish are found in open waters, like Lake Victoria, Lake Kyoga, Lake Tanganyika, Lake Baringo, and Lake Turkana. While crocodiles and hippos are found in freshwater lakes and large rivers, especially Nile, Tana, Zoia, Ruvuma, and Mara. Number four, we have natural vegetation. Are habitat to the elephants, buffaloes, gorillas, baboon, and monkey, others and others. Savannah grassland are homes to the herbivorous animals. The grass provide food to them, like gazelles, antelopes, wild beasts, zebras, buffaloes, that in return attract to carnivores. And these areas where we have the shrubs and bushes, they are habitat to animals like the warthogs, hyrax, and other carnivores. Human activities. Fishing methods that lead to the overexploitation or overfishing may make certain fish to be extincted. Then encroachment of the wildlife habitat for the settlement and also agriculture due to the increasing population. Mining and quarrying activities destroy plant cover and animal habitats. Pollution of waters and with time kills the wildlife and reduce their numerous number. Activity, explain four factors that influence the distribution of the wildlife in East Africa. Then define wildlife. For reference, you can visit the KRB 2003 Secondary Geography Student Book 4, that edition. If at all you want to contact us, you can get us from the SMS. You can also get us from the YouTube. You can get us from the Facebook and from the Twitter. Stay tuned to Tourim TV. Thank you.